Oh, you're shaking. What's wrong with you?
I'm nervous.
Oh my God.
I'm Annie Onishi.
Annie is a trauma surgeon. She's explained operating rooms and surgical procedures in Technique Critique.
As I tell my medical students, vitals are vital. We always talk about them. We always want to know what they are. And yes, we ask what they are on the regular.
And I'm Peter Rubin.
Peter is a Wired contributor who covers culture and technology. Annie is going to teach Peter how to suture and tie surgical knots using different materials, ranging from easy to difficult.
Hey, Peter, you want to know about surgical knot tying and suturing technique?
About time I cross it off my bucket list.
Let's get you into some scrubs.
Excellent.
The first thing we'll learn today is surgical knot tying.
How much does this have in common with tying a friendship bracelet?
This is 100% the same activity as tying a friendship bracelet.
Oh my God, I'm gonna get the marshmallows, let's do this.
So typically medical students will learn this during the first few days of their surgery rotations, and it's an activity that's mastered over hours and hours of practice. So there's actually two types of knots. There's the two-handed knot and the one-handed knot. Today I'm gonna be teaching you the one-handed knot.
Is that because it's easier?
Turns out it's not easier, it's just more applicable in general practice. This is a knot that we tie everywhere, whether it be we're fixing the inferior vena cava during a major trauma case, you're sewing little arteries on the heart, or even things as simple as you're closing skin of a little laceration in the emergency room. It's all the same knot. So Peter, to help you learn knot tying, today I brought you the Surgery Resident Starter Pack.
So is this like an official training tool? Is this what people are gonna start using in med school?
This is pretty darn official. When students are first learning how to tie knots, they use multicolored large bore yarn, just like this. The reason the color is helpful, it will show you that your knot is lying perfectly as you tie it. In a one-handed tie, there's actually two knots. There's a forehand throw and a backhand throw.
Okay.
All right, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take the white string and hold it in my left hand so that my purple is crossed. See that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. My forehand throw has an overhand grip like this, like you're riding the pony.
Okay.
Can you ride the pony a little
riding
bit?
Riding the pony.
Riding the pony. So with your strings crossed, you're going to create a four shape. Do you see the four?
I do.
Now, your index finger is going to go through the four and loop this tail and bring it through the four.
Loop that tail and bring it through the four.
Just like that.
Just like that. Good. The whole thing?
Bring the whole tail through.
Whole tail through.
Now, with your right hand and your left hand, you're going to put the knot down and it should be nice and square. That's excellent, Peter. Good.
I'm so a doctor.
You're a doctor. So that's your forehand throw.
Okay.
Now, for your backhand throw, left hand comes back to neutral position with the right string. Adjust your grip on the purple string to a karate chop grip.
Okay.
Now, use your middle finger to get the tail through the four.
What?
The tail. Maintaining tension on that
maintaining
white tail.
Maintaining tension.
And bring it through.
Bring it through.
Yeah.
Oh, through
yes.
Like that. Oh.
Now you need to cross your hands.
Okay.
So let's try it again.
Okay.
And then you alternate forehand, backhand.
Okay. Where are you likely to use this sort of knot chain?
So this is a knot that we tie everywhere, whether it be we're fixing the inferior vena cava during a major trauma case, you're sewing little arteries on the heart, or even things as simple as you're closing skin of a little laceration in the emergency room. It's all the same knot.
Mm.
It's just a matter of what you're tying, what kind of suture. So you are doing this as a chain. Now, depending on the suture material you're using, the most knots you would ever tie is like 8 or 10.
Okay, now,
okay,
here's the
problem.
Okay,
stop, freeze. Here's the difference between me and you. Look where your purple string is versus where my purple string is.
Oh, mine's you've got it around the whole
pinky,
hand.
And that's gonna give you a little bit of tension to make this guy easier.
Oh, but I still got ham hands.
You can do it. You can do it. These can't be ham hands.
Check this out.
Oh my god, good.
One hand.
Oh my god, I'm gonna hire you.
Just like the name of the knot.
Great.
I look at yours and I see friendship.
Friendship.
And here I see rancor and years of bitterness.
Indeed.
So I have a feeling that the answer to this is going to be everything, but what am I doing wrong?
I think the problem is coming as the knot is going down. You're not applying even tension, so your knots are ending up stacked instead of square.
Yes.
When we teach the medical students how to do this, they're just doing it constantly. You find little strings tied to everything, the mouse, the computer, their pants.
Oh yeah, you really don't have to do much when you cross back over to the
right.
Forehand, do you?
Yeah. You got it done.
Now what happens when the ends start getting short?
Then you're done.
Then I'm done.
Right.
Oh.
This is good to learn the mechanics of the knots.
But this
doesn't sit like real suture. So why don't we move on to something more difficult? I actually brought some suture material to show you.
Okay.
So the way that suture is labeled is 0 is sort of the middle set point. And something like a 6-0 is tiny, tiny. That means 6 zeros all in a row. The easiest thing to tie is 0 silk.
And is 6-0 the thinnest you can use?
Absolutely not. It goes all the way down to like 10-0, but that's used on very fine things like a vein or an artery or a nerve. Mm. So for you, Peter, we're going to use sort of the elementary school 0 silk. This is the same exact thing as your yarn, but what's going to make this a little harder is that your suture's finer. So you're going to have to work harder to keep good tension and to make it sit nice. So again, the mechanics are the same. It's really important that you sort of follow the knot down with your finger to get the knot to sit exactly where you want it to sit. All right, Peter, so let's see.
So I had this forehand throw. Mm-hmm. You see that?
Good.
Jargon.
And use your...
Oh,
there
use
you
the...
go. Yes. You see how your... That was very instinctive, what you did. Your hand sort of crawled up the suture. That's perfect.
No, karate chop. Good. I call it, now in my brain, this is ham hands because I have ham hands.
No, you have beautiful hands. You have healing hands. Don't do that. So, Peter, I actually think you're ready for the next curveball.
Oh, boy.
Which is, okay. Let's get you to do this with gloves on.
So there's no, like, in between. It's going from the training wheels to the
Hell
Grand Prix.
Yeah,
okay. So do doctors actually do the thing where they're like, yeah, let's do this?
100%,
okay.
Every time.
Let's do this then.
Yeah. Okay, so let's get started. So, Peter, this is just going to be the same thing. Same knots, but I just want you to get a sense for how it feels different when you can't actually, you know, feel the suture material directly on your skin.
It's almost like numbness. Wow. Hey, guess what? I'm even more terrible. I didn't think this was possible. That's not a sound you like to hear.
It's just interesting. A million different people.
It's the other thing you like to hear.
Well, they just.
That's interesting.
Every different person. Makes their own unique mistake when they're learning how to
this. Your euphemisms are the best.
Keep going. You're doing great.
Okay. What do you got there?
In real life, your hands are wet.
Oh, hey. Okay. So this is what, like the bodily fluid
of
my choosing?
And so actually, silk, because it's a braided suture, doesn't make too much of a difference.
Yes. I thought it would be a lot worse.
But if I give you a monofilament, which is like a plastic one strand, that will be harder with your hands wet. But you're doing really good.
Yay!
Yeah. You've really, I think, mastered the mechanics of the knot tying. You would just need some polishing in terms of your tension, your knot placement.
So what's going to be next here? What are we going to do?
So I have just the thing. I have these creepy skin models with a bunch of different types of incisions.
What?
Yep.
It's solid, and it's kind of a little giving, but it's dense.
It feels kind of real. So I have for you here a suture kit. And a 4-0 biocin on a cutting needle. And a cutting needle is what we use to close skin with. This is an absorbable monofilament.
Okay.
4-0, so that's a little smaller than you've been working with. So the first thing you have here is a needle driver, and every surgical instrument locks in place. Mm-hmm. So practice that mechanism, and then real surgeons don't put their thumb in that hole. Push it with the butt of your hand and then close it. And then you also need these pickups. These are rough approximations of Adson forceps with teeth. So these have teeth on the end of it that help you grip skin.
These aren't tweezers.
These are not tweezers.
These are not tweezers.
These are called pickups.
Pickups.
And then that's the needle in there.
Okay.
So be careful. And you're gonna...
Oh, you put your thumb in the hole.
Just for that part.
Oh, hypocrisy.
Good.
Take the whole thing out?
Yep.
Ooh.
Okay.
Wait. 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 Okay.
Okay. Okay. So now, the way to properly hold the needle, use your pickups to help you. So I'm going to hold my needle halfway back at a 45 degree angle here and at the very tips of my needle driver. All right, so now we're ready to close skin. So what I'm going to teach you now is called the running subcuticular closure.
Okay.
Say it with me.
Running subcuticular closure.
Okay, and this is a nice way to make the skin come together and there's no stitches visible.
Okay.
So I'm gonna pick up the edge of the quote-unquote skin, take one bite sort of right in the apex of this skin.
Is bite also a technical term?
It is. I'm gonna then what's called protect my needle. Sure. So now the sharp end of the needle is protected against this pickups.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
And I'm just gonna do a couple of one-handed ties. Usually three or four for this. I'm alternating. And then when you get to the end, I'll show you what to do. You want to try?
No, but I guess I have to. I want to keep it exposed like there.
Sure.
Yeah. Sure. There we go.
Good.
Back to the failure euphemism.
Release your needle driver.
I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. Push it from behind. Because you don't usually want to touch the tip of this needle because you don't want to either break it or make it dull. So now what you're going to do is protect your needle. That's it. Perfect. Pull through. Good. And now you're ready to tie. Do 4 single-handed throws like you learned.
Okay, now the color of the skin and the color of the filament.
Yeah.
There is not a lot of contrast going on here. Can I cheat with this?
No. Ugh. Yeah, I'm just going to help you, and then, because the point of this exercise is to sew, not to tie.
Oh, yeah.
You're doing so good. I'm so proud of you.
I'm doing good. All right, so we're going to pretend that I did that.
Right.
And now it's anchored.
Yep. So then a running subcuticular closure, if you use your imagination, is going to end up like a series of C's in the plane of the skin. So then your next bite, you're going to evert the opposite side of the skin. You're going to enter the tissue sort of exactly opposite to where you came out. And again, you're just going to kind of run along the dimension of the skin just like so. You're going to use the back of the needle to push it along. And if you're super slick, you'll load your needle while it's held down there for you.
Hmm. And so the only knots are really to anchor it at the beginning.
Exactly. Yep. And so you just kind of bring it together like that. So you're going to pick up on this side.
But I did it that way.
That's okay. So turn your body. So, yep, that's it. So when you're the operating surgeon, you can hip check people. You have to get yourself comfortable.
Out of my way. There's a patient on the table.
Okay, so you're actually going to come along this dimension.
Okay. Yeah. Like so.
Again, use your pickups to put the tissue where you want it to go.
To put the tissue where I want it to go. I am stuck, but that's enough to get it out, I hope.
Yeah. And you know, in real subcuticular tissue, you want to come out inside the wound so that the stitch gets hidden, but that's okay. For our purposes, that's your first bite, that's fine. The point of this closure is that you don't see any suture.
So am I going across or am I going along?
No, now you're going across.
Now I'm going across.
But again, use your pickups to show yourself where you want to go. So move along, make more progress, which means take a bite with your pickups closer to your body. Good.
So, and I come across here?
Right, but this is in this dimension. So
right.
Right.
Ah.
Good. And now with this hand, push the tissue.
Where are you?
There you go. That's perfect. Great.
Yeah.
Let go.
All right, video's over.
Let go.
Pull this out. Oh, hey,
look, it's closing. I know.
All right, now I
But at this rate, it's going to heal before you even finish.
Yeah.
Even if they don't look perfect, these tend to heal up, okay? But you can make this look like nothing ever happened.
Which is kind of the...
Which is not what's happening to your patient.
Oh, well, they're going to have a nice memento of their time with
That's
them.
Right.
All right, so let's assume that the rest of this is going to go flawlessly.
Like this. So, Peter, once you get to the end, you're going to close this with what's called an Aberdeen hitch.
Okay.
So take your post. Again, we're protected here. And get your right hand through that loop. And you're going to go grab your post and bring it through your knot. Don't let your loop get too small.
Oh, okay. Okay, so I got one.
Good.
Do another one.
Yep.
Keep tension on the post. Don't let the loop get too small. Mm-hmm. Pull on that, and that'll go down.
Pull just the bottom one. Just this one. There you go.
Oh.
Just that bottom one. Good. And then one more.
One more.
Okay. Put that whole thing through.
Yes.
Yep. Nice. Very good.
Oh. Oh, no.
Okay, go ahead.
Spoke too soon.
Okay, now reload your needle.
All right,
so now you're going to bury this knot, so just take a bite. Like behind it and come out over here.
Do I want to evert like
Stop
that?
Stop holding your pickups like that.
Oh, come on, buddy. Oh no.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
So just pick this up. That's fine. At this point, the patient has healed miraculously on his own.
Is awake, is thanking me profusely.
Yep, ready to be discharged home. Good. So then your assistant cuts this, and then once you're done with the suture, you pass it off to the scrub, protect it, and you say needle back.
Needle back,
and
thank
that's
you.
That. Look how nice.
Look how beautiful that is, the thing you did 80% of.
The point of this is that the suture is hidden, so they don't need to get them removed, and that they just dissolved. All right, Peter, are you ready for the next lesson?
Yes, please.
Okay. Nurse, bring in the patients.
I've never seen anything quite like this, doctor.
The most severe case I've seen yet.
All right, what are we going to do with this? I think there's already some sort of thing going.
I see a little bruise. Well, I think first we'll make a little laceration, then we'll close it up.
Sometimes you have to hurt things to heal them.
So true. 2 bananas were harmed in the making of this video.
Yeah, and is this how you would make an actual incision?
Oh, no. Normally an incision is with a firm hand and a straight line and just all the way down, yeah. It just depends on what kind of operation you're doing.
And so where would you see this?
This is in a skinny guy like you, inguinal hernia.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Well, let's just pretend I'm stitching up my own inguinal hernia.
There you go. Okay. So for this particular model, it's best to close a banana laceration with a simple interrupted nylon suture. Orthopedics surgeons will use it, ER docs will use it, but it's sort of a simpler, more straightforward way to close. Okay, so this is just gonna pick up on the skin, take a nice bite, come right across.
So how much room should I leave behind for the knot?
You wanna pull through because you're gonna put a couple of these in.
So, and then, which is my post? Is this my post?
Yeah, protect your needle.
Oh, protect your needle. So the filament that we're using, what kind of grade is this? With
thickness? So this is a 3-0 nylon. So nylon is a monofilament, non-absorbable suture. And 3-0 is slightly larger than the 4-0 you were just working with.
All right, so we got it knotted.
Yeah, so then I would actually trim your tails and you would put in a separate knot. That's the interrupted.
Oh, so each time.
Exactly, and then as opposed to running. So as you can see, I did what you did, and then I cut my tails, and I started again. This is called an interrupted closure.
Got to trim the tails, start over.
Good.
All right.
What are your pickups doing right now? Two hands. What are your pickups doing? You're going to rip. Careful. Yeah. Okay, so when it's really short,
do we do something
that the orthopods and the ER docs do, but the general surgeons don't do, which is called an instrument tie. So it's the same knot, but you're just gonna do it with your instrument. And again, general surgeons don't usually do this.
Why didn't you show me that one?
Because it's cheesy and it's not nice and it's not delicate and it's not civilized. It looks easier, though.
It
is easier, but it's not civilized. So I mean, you've got the basic skills down, the knot tying, the suturing. I think the things that would get built up to be a little bit more realistic is a wide open body cavity, blood everywhere, everyone's yelling, patient's not doing well, you're really nervous, you're exhausted. That's probably a little bit more real life.
This is suboptimal skin conditions we're
Indeed.
Dealing with here.
Yeah, your resident may have to redo your skin closure on this one, but
seems right.
Some patients are more difficult than others. I wouldn't take it too personally.
Well, Annie, thank you for taking the time to show me all this stuff. May it never come in handy, but I'm glad that there are people like you to make sure that it does.
You should always shake hands with your assistant before you leave the OR.
That is what that is.